Hello and welcome to the Front Row with myself, Roanna Moodley. And today is Thursday, which means it's time for your desi dose of beauty with me. Today I decided to do a halo hooded eye look. So if you want to see how I got this look, then please keep on watching. I've just put concealer on my eyelids, but I haven't put too much on my eyelids because I am going to use concealer for the halo eye, so I didn't want to like overdo it on my eye so it doesn't become too creamy. I've decided that I'm going to use my NYX Perfect Filter Shadow Palette, and this is the Rustic Antique one. It's obviously the one I use all the time, but I thought I would go with these two combinations, which is that and that for the halo eye, and let's just see what happens. What I decided to do is I don't want to do too many colors because again, my makeup routine is not complicated at all and I like it to be very simple to follow and easy to do. So even if you'd want to do something glamorous and a little bit different, it is quite easy to follow. So I'm going to take a flat brush like this and I'm going to dip into the dark color. This is a matte finish color and I'm just going to place it on the eye here, and then I want to take a little bit and push it into the socket of where my eye, you feel the socket, and create almost like a fake crease. So I'm going to put this color in the inside corner and then the outside corner. Then I'm going to take my blending brush and I'm just going to soften the lines that I've made in a circular motion so that it doesn't look harsh. Next, I'm going to take my Pro Concealer in the color Creamy Beige. I'm going to put some on my hand like this and I'm going to use this to help me create the halo look. So we're going to put a few dots, open my eye, and that's where we would use that line as a guide. What I like to do is do kind of like a basket shape on my eye, like so. It doesn't have to be incredibly perfect, just as long as you've got the shape down, you should be okay. Now I'm going to use my finger and go in with the shimmery and tap, use a tapping motion to place the shimmer eyeshadow on the concealer. Now, because we want to create the illusion of a crease, I'm going to go in with this chocolate color from Rimmel and I'm just going to place this in the same sockets underneath the eyeshadow that I've got. And I'm going to take my blending brush and I'm going to blend that crease that I've created. Next, it's time to go back in with the darker eyeshadow and blend it into the crease that I've created. Now I'm going to do the other eye and I'll be back. All right, so both eyes are done and I am ready to do my face before continuing on with the eyes. I'm going to use my Kiki primer. This primer is velvet smooth primer to increase makeup hold and coverage. It softens the appearance of fine lines and imperfections. You can wear it alone as a moisturizer or you can use it under your makeup. So that's what's great about this. This primer goes down very well and it really does act as a great moisturizer. Next, I'm going to go in with my Fit Me 250 so I can have an even more poreless vibe going on. And for concealer and my contour, I'm going to go in with my new favorite, which is the Maybelline Instant Eraser. This concealer is so good that it blends out perfectly. To set my concealer, I'm going to use baby powder, which is my favorite things to do because you just need a little bit like that. And push it into the skin everywhere that I place the concealer in. Now I smile a lot, so I don't want my foundation moving and I don't want it to look cakey, so I do my smile lines as well. To set my contour, I'm going to use Stay Matte But Not Flat, just a tad bit. And let's put some blush on. We're gonna use the Sweet Cheeks palette and sweep that up. Next, I'm going to match what I've done on the top at the bottom. So I'm going to put the darker color on the edges and join it to the top. And the shimmery color in the middle to complete the look. Next, I'm going to take my Hey Gorgeous mascara. For highlighter, I'm using the pinky shimmery color on the high points of my face. For lips, I'm using my Essence Contour Stick and this is Going Steady in the number 9. And we are definitely going steady with this brand. And then for lipstick, I'm going to use my Avon Pink Doll lipstick color. This is a very, very bright color, so I don't really want to make it too bright. So I'm going to use a dabbing motion. We are going to set this baby with Kiki Beauty Rose Dew Setting Spray. So this is the look. If you liked this look, please do give this video a thumbs up and comment below letting me know what other looks you'd like to see. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel because it does help me so, so much. And I guess I'll catch you on the next video. Keep it royal.